Yo, happy Friday. Got a couple of things. I'm gonna give you guys some information. I just want to say happy Friday to you and all you athletes out there, student athletes. RBGU tapping in, Coach Randle tapping in. I got my guy Mike tapping in. And he's gonna explain, we're just gonna partner up and explain exactly what this RBGU thing is all about, because we get constant questions all the time. So we're gonna give you some information about what I do, what you see, because I do get a lot of questions. I have about 20 questions right here. So we're gonna be answering some questions. And yes, that's my jersey right there, very proud of that. And that's Rashad Penny's jersey right there, very proud of that too. You can also see him on my page. You can also Google that man, Rashad Penny. He actually plays for the Seattle Seahawks first round draft pick. And you've probably seen his older brother that I've been working with. He plays for the New York Giants. He is Saquon Barkley's fullback. So if Saquon Barkley, man, check this out, bro. We need you to get about 2K. We need you to get 2,000 rushing yards, man. Please, I know Elijah's ready for it. Then yeah, if you look back here, you can get to see that right there too. So let me see if my man is tapping in. Oh, he ain't tapping in just yet. But so like I said, this information we're gonna give you. We're gonna talk about what is RBGU, what is the COVID safe training sessions that I have for you guys. And if you have any questions, please tap in. Please ask me a question. I'll definitely give you some answers. Cause like I said, I have about, I'm looking at my iPad. I got about 28 questions asking, hey, can you train? You train linebackers? Do you train corners, wide receivers? Yeah. What's up, Ryder? Ryder Vaez right there. That guy's going to be going to Chaparral. He's a Puma. I had Ryder for about 2 years in my homeschool academy. That guy's going to be really, really special. Very hardworking, very dedicated. Look out for young Ryder, man. Who else is tapped in? Let me see. Yeah, okay, he's filling up. My brother, shout out to my big bro, Kumasi. That's one of my stories that I need to tell. That's probably going to take about 2 days. Shout out to Kumasi, my big bro, my blood brother. He's really, really, really a part of my big story too. I remember one time, I think I might have been in ninth grade or maybe eighth grade or something like that. He said, look, before y'all drop you off at the mall, we gonna have to do 500 yard lunges. And I'm just like, what? 500 yard, yeah, 500 yard lunges. So yeah, shout out to my brother Kumasi out there, the Lion Trainer. You can check him out. His tag is EL_A_King, LA King. So definitely tap in with him. If you're out there in that Norwalk, LA area, he's definitely heavy in the USC area when it comes to going to games, getting some information. He has a lot of access, so definitely tap in with him. Waiting for one more dude to tap in. Oh, there you go. Okay, let me get him going. Come on, tap in with me. Let me see if I can get this guy going. All right, so yeah, we're gonna be answering a couple of questions for you. Let me see if I can get this guy to join in. How do I do this thing? Here we go. Send it like that. And let's see if I can add him in. Waiting for old Mikey. There we go. So like I said, there's going to be some topics. Oh, there you go. There he is. There's the guy. The guy's there.
What's up, man?
Yo, what's happening, man, with the gold chain? I see the gold chain.
Oh, yeah. You know, a little something.
Yeah. As you should be. So, yeah, I was just letting the people know what's going on, giving them some information. I was telling them Happy Friday. You could also tell them Happy Friday to RBGU people.
Yeah.
So, like I said, I was just telling the people that we're going to be answering the questions that they have about the training, about different positions, about the brand, and about what we're concentrating on and what we actually do. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah.
If you people have any questions, definitely just ask, because we're right here. We tapped in with you. So
how I pin a comment, I'm just going to put RBG in there. See how okay. it
goes. It should go like this. Let me do that too. I'm gonna say, yeah, you got it, and then pin it.
Y'all can put RBGU conversation.
Yep. Much needed. Much needed combo. So the first thing I want to get into is this, and I'm gonna just ask you the question real quick. What is RBGU?
RBGU, man. Glad you asked. You know, RBGU is a lifestyle brand pushing the look good, play good. Play good, pay good theory as a culture. You know, we influence youth and professional athletic development. And what that entails is, you know, growing up, one thing that I think I missed out on a lot is having guidance in sports. You feel me? Like I could play, you know, I was athletic. I kind of knew the game, but I really didn't understand the game within the game. And that's what RBGU provides. That's what we bring. What we want to do with a lot of kids is, like we said, we start with youth and professionals. So we cover all bases. We cover, you know, the 6 and 7 and 8 year olds to the 10 and 11, 13 year olds to the seniors and juniors in high school, all the way up to the freshmen, sophomores and juniors in college, all the way up to 5 year veterans in the NFL, to 2 year guys, to rookies in the NFL, undrafted free agents, first round draft picks. It's a lot, you know.
Hey, CFL players. I also had a player.
CFL players, I had
a player named JoJo Mathis. He's over here in Japan playing overseas. So, yeah.
Softball players, all that.
All the above. So, also like he said, even softball players. There's one softball player athlete. She's over at Fresno State. Her name is, I want to say, Alexis Dimby. She's a softball player. She was out of Vista Marietta. But look, yeah, man, let's jump into the next little question. And part of my little Wayne playing in the background. I'm sorry. I don't know if you guys can hear that. So when it comes to RBGU and what's happening and what these people are seeing, can you explain to them when it comes to the training? I just have a question that I'm reading off of. It says, do you only train running backs?
Oh, no, sir. No, sir. Look, here we go. You guys see the hoodie right here. It's Running Back Guru University. You see the U, it stands out. The U goes for university. Now, I attended a university. Coach Randle there, he attended a university. So what you can see, if you're anticipating on attending a university, I'll tell you right now, it's not a place where you just go to do one thing. You know, when you go to a university, when you're in class, you're sitting next to a soon-to-be doctor. You're sitting next to a soon-to-be, you know, preschool teacher. You're sitting next to a soon-to-be sports agent, a lawyer. You know, when you come to a university, it's a one-stop shop to learn everything, all positions, all walks of life. It's just getting you ready for the game. So when you come to RBGU, let's say you're a linebacker, Coach Randle has a lot of experience running over linebackers, or linebackers chasing Coach Randle. So he's going to teach you the exact way to attack somebody like him. This is what you're getting from RBGU. You're going to get not only extreme training, but you're going to get the IQ level of, I'm a running back. When I see a linebacker, this is what I expect a linebacker to do. This is almost a mirror now. You're almost getting a double mirror now. When you have Coach Randle, who played at the highest level, he was a dog, you know, when he was a little pup, then he was a dog when he went to varsity, then he was a dog when he was in college, and he was a dog when he was in pro. So you're getting a dog showing you what he expects from another player. That's intense. Because a lot of coaches, a lot of trainers, they watch a lot of football, you know, not necessarily play. And when you come to RBGU, you're getting a play-by-play. You're getting intense training. You're getting intense IQ from a running back perspective, from an athlete's perspective, from a professional's perspective. He's going to teach you the defensive side, the offensive side, special team side. And I want to make it clear, we're not just a football-based, you know, sports brand. You know, we're training basketball players, boys and girls. We're training softball players. We're training baseball players. I've seen a lot of people hit us up, you know, from different countries, you know, asking us if we train male volleyball players. So I'm like, you know, RBGU, we're just trying to get the best out of you. You know, your best sports ability. We're trying to pull it out of you, and you, a dog might be in you. We're just here to wake it up, you know?
Absolutely. Absolutely. And that's touched on all categories. The next question I had, it says, let me read it clearly. What about social media? What can I learn about social media while working under RBGU?
That's a great question there. Social media. See, social media is a fairly new concept. A lot of people, they just think it's just apps, internet, but it's not. Social media, when it comes to RBGU, we specialize in marketing. A lot of people don't know. I attended Grambling State University in 2009. From 2009 to 2012, I attended Grambling State, then I went to UCR. I was the first ever social media manager for the university. And what I learned, and I interned at ESPN. This is 2009. This is almost 10 years ago. I'm an old dog. But what we wanted to teach these athletes is these tweets that you just ha-ha kiki-ing outside with your friends, those don't go away. You know, those the coach that might be recruiting you, he might go to Twitter and search your name, and let's say there's a new word we don't want to use, and he might search it and he might pull it up, and he's just sitting there looking at you use it all day freely. Right. We over here at RBGU, we want to teach you guys that this is a business. The same way you act when you're on the practice field, the same way you act in the classroom, we want you to act that same way when you're on your social media. We're gonna teach you how to market yourself. We're gonna teach you how to brand yourself.
And Mike, let me piggyback on what you just said with me reading this question. When we were down there in, I think it was Santa Monica Beach, some beach.
Oh, yeah.
Daniel Jones. Yeah. Okay, so Daniel Jones, first round draft pick with the Giants. We were having a conversation about social media, so we're just trying to mention the guys about the social media.
Yeah, we were having a talk. We were talking. Oh, this is before Daniel Jones appeared on anybody's draft.
Yeah,
board.
This is before he came. Danny Dimes.
Danny Dimes. Yeah. So we're sitting there post workout, right? We got the guys in a circle, and it's on our RBGU profile. If you guys want to check that out, we got the guys in a circle, and what I say is, I tell them just real briefly, you know, if you guys are at these Dukes, if you guys are at these USCs, use that as much as they use you, you know, because every time you throw a pass, they're going to put your face all over it, you know, they're going to put your face everywhere. So you do the same, you know, put it back out there, you know, market yourself. And when Danny Dimes, he rebutted as Tom Brady and Drew Brees, they didn't need to do that. Why do I need to do it? I'm like, yo, Tom Brady and Drew Brees were in college in like 1999. So,
so they didn't have all this.
It's a different ball game. You know what you want to do? You want to market that, because let's say what's a guy? There's a
Odell
guy.
Beckham Jr., Cam Newton,
yeah, Odell,
Von Miller, Shaquille O'Neal. He's on it now, but Shaquille O'Neal's out the league, so he's trying to play catch up too.
It's heavy, man. Social media marketing. You can get a check from this if you behave the right way. If you can draw in the right numbers, if you can articulate yourself, if you can be presentable. You don't want to be on here doing any of that quarantine radio stuff.
You don't want to be SpongeBob SquarePants on here, man.
You don't want to do none of that. You don't want to have paraphernalia in the background. You don't want to say things you're not supposed to. If you treat it right, it'll bless you. Social media will bless you, especially if you treat it right, if you market it right, if you brand it right, if you put the right stuff out there. You're a student. This is one thing one of my mentors told me. You guys are students at these universities. If it's a San Diego State, if it's a USC, if it's a Fresno State, treat those guys that are in your class who are not on the football team, treat those guys like they are your brothers as well, because you never know. You might be sitting next to the next U.S. senator. You might be sitting next to a guy in your class who might be
Bill Gates,
a district attorney one day. These people, a Google executive. Football, sports is not forever. You know, you want to make those connections. You want to shake hands. You want to like a picture of somebody. You know, if you're the quarterback or the safety of a school and you like the regular student's picture, that goes a long way, man. So behave the right way with RBGU and social media. This is what we teach. This is what we practice. And we're not just
we're giving a lot of game.
This for the young kids. This for the young kids. You guys might not understand this reference. Some of the older parents, they might understand. Some of us might understand. But we're not trying to be all up in the videos dancing. We're not trying to be, you know, get all the views and the likes. We're not trying to do all that, man. You know, if you want to do that, there's a place for it, I'm sure. But when you come to RBGU, our main goal is scholarships and contracts. That's it. We're not trying to get you going. Trending.
Please tap that in there, Mike. Please tap that in there. You can write that in there, Mike.
Go ahead, write that in there. Scholarships and contracts, man. That's
Please,
what I'm
write it in there, all caps. I got one more question for you, too. I'll let you finish that right in, and I'm gonna read this question that I have. This comes from one of the students that attended the HBCU, and I know you attended the HBCU. Attending the HBCU, what were your thoughts? How were you feeling about it, and what was your experiences? So I know you attended the HBCU. So give them your feelings and your thoughts and your experience attending.
For all those who don't know, the HBCU is a historically black college and university. Me, myself, I was not big on school. You know, I had a mother who was a counselor at my high school. She was applying to a ton of schools for me, schools I didn't even know about. I actually got offered to play basketball at certain schools in Texas, certain schools in California. But my mom, she was applying to schools without my knowledge. And she comes home one day and she's like, son, you got accepted to all these schools except Morehouse, which I still got a bone to pick with Morehouse. But I got Grambling State University. I seen it and I'm like, oh, I kind of know what that is. Let me mm-hmm. see. They got a basketball team. Let me do my research. I did the research. Mm-hmm. I was playing basketball at a tournament in Vegas. I seen that the school was still recruiting. Went ahead and called the coach. And this is coming from a guy who was not top ranked. I didn't break any records in high school. This is just a regular old athlete, you know, and this is the benefit of going to HBCU. I went ahead and called the coach. His name was Coach Stitt. I'm like, yo, Coach Stitt, man, I'm interested in coming to Grambling State. I play basketball. You know, I'm a 6-foot guard. Et cetera, et cetera. I see you guys still recruiting. You know, if you guys don't know, I'm at this tournament in Vegas. You guys can come see me play. He's like, actually, Mike, I am at that tournament in Vegas. What time you play? And I'm like, at first, I kind of wanted to kind of just call that bluff, you know, like, hey, I'm at the tournament in Vegas. I'm hooping. But I thought I was going to get like, oh, you know, we're not, but send us some tape. And so he's like, actually, I am at this tournament in Vegas. What time do you play? And I'm like, oh, okay. I play at 3, coach. that game happened. My mom went back. This is right after I graduated. So I'm a senior doing this. Right? Mm-hmm. I'm a senior doing this. Graduating, done with high school, got 2 more weeks of just travel basketball. My mom gets an email while she's still in work. She says, hey, son, the coach actually liked how you play. He just wants to know if you're interested on coming in as a walk-on. If you can come in as a walk-on, if you can earn a spot, you feel me? You can earn a spot, and if you work really hard. My bad, my dog up there going crazy. I think somebody's trying to break in. But he said you can earn a spot, and if you work really hard, you can earn either a partial or a scholarship. So for me, I'm a guy who I never had anything handed to me, no silver spoon, no, not really expected anything under the Christmas tree. So I'm like, that means I can eat, you know? That means my plate is empty and somebody else's plate is full. So I'm like, okay, let me figure out how I'm gonna get my napkins and get ready to go eat. So I only have one question for the coach. I'm like, okay, does it snow, coach? And he's like, no, not really. Cause I'm a California guy. If it snows, I can't promise you I'm gonna go to class, coach. so he's like, nah, not really. Maybe once or twice it'll snow. By that time, you should be long gone back to California. So I went ahead and I went on. For those who do not know, going to HBCU changed my life, man. I'm gonna tell you guys, just to make a long story short, I had a teammate pass away in the middle of my recruiting, and all my coaches got fired. So they put us on hold, the kind of delayed recruits. But they made us play a lot of statewide basketball that were on the B team. You know, if you go to college, you understand that a lot of the guys that got like JV team, varsity teams, some of the B team guys. We got to play like schools like LSU's B team. What's that school? Louisiana Tech's B team. We got to play those guys. We did great. You know, we was all freshman team. We didn't have any sophomores or juniors or seniors on that team. Right. So we were doing real great.
Came in heavy, ready to go.
Yeah, just came in. We were hungry. You know, you told us to earn a spot. Yo, we gonna earn it. We had nothing to lose at that point. We're freshmen. Right. My mentor there, I majored in history. I got a work study. For those who may not know, when you go to college, you know, jobs are scarce. You need a job. You know, I got a work study. I was the sports information director. I took stats for the volleyball team. I took stats for the football team. I took stats for we had a bowling team as well. You know, I was always in the back on a computer, you know, point dexter type stuff. Just because growing up, my mom was a coach, so she had me on the bench taking stats as well. So it's just kind of I'm just kind of used to being around sports. A fellow sports director, he saw that. My friend was like, hey Mike, I know you're into sports. I'm not really into sports. I want to introduce you to somebody who's a sports information director. I got the interview for that, got a job there. That man led me to intern at ESPN. This is 2009. This is 10 plus years ago. And this is the benefits of going to an HBCU. I got to go intern at ESPN. I got to do social media there too. I got to do sports. I did statistics. I did a lot of logging information. I got to meet Coach Saban. I got to meet a lot of coaches throughout the time. I got to travel, shake hands. The first black quarterback to win a Super Bowl was the coach my second year. So I got to spend time around him. Doug Williams, I got to spend a lot of time around him. I got to see how he was treated in the media. So that kind of got me my mindset right to kind of market and produce and help and direct RBGU. A lot of the content you guys see the first time around, Brad and I, we don't have a media team. You know, Brad and Coach Randle and I, we don't have people we send stuff to and they make it cute for you. No. It's just us. Just
one and two.
Yeah, just two young men with a vision and a dream, and we put our heads together and we figured it out. And a lot of that stuff I would have never had I not gone to an HBCU. My teachers knew my name. My counselors knew my name. You might think that, oh, mom's not here. I don't got to go to class. You know, you might be walking through the thing, you know, talking mess.
Possibility.
And a coach is and a baseball coach. He's like, Mike, what's that? You got history. I'm like, oh, boy. And I'm knowing he's a baseball coach, so he's probably going to go tell the basketball coach. So I'm like, yeah, I'm going.
That's like, a quick text.
Yeah. He's like, but it's over there. You already over here. What you doing? And I'm like, okay, my bad. You know, so it just holds you accountable. And for me, as a young black man going to an HBCU, I got to see other young black people, you know, striving to be dentists, striving to be lawyers, striving to be sports agents, striving to be. I have a guy right now who's he's at NYU and he went to school with me at Grambling State. I also have a lady. She's down in Florida. She is the regional director for a couple charter schools. And this is us. We're young. I'm 29. She's 29. And this is the stuff that we got from going to HBCU. It holds you accountable, makes you prideful in what and who you are and what you look like. It gives you opportunities that you may not get at a bigger school, at a school with a lot of people because it's so flooded. You might not be a legacy. You know, your dad's dad may have not gone to University of Alabama. You know, so it's going to be hard for you to get into that door. But you can go to another place that's open for you, that's proud to have you, that's going to hold you accountable, that's going to make you go to class. You know, you can't call up coach and be like, hey, coach, man, you know, I didn't want to go to class today. He's going to be like, oh, I guess you don't want to play this week, you know, type stuff. So it's like you got to really hold yourself accountable, and it makes you like, actually, my sister right now, she's a triple jumper at Grambling State on the track team. So we're trying to build a legacy because in our family, we are the first ones to go straight from high school to college. And so if you put that in account, the people in our family to go straight from high school to college, we went from straight from high school to HBCU. And it's just me and her, the first two. I'm the oldest, I'm the firstborn, and she was the last born. And we were the first two to do that. So that's really a big thing for us.
No, that's definitely good, man. That's history for your family, and I know you got two little kids, so you know, man. I know where they probably gonna go.
Yeah, so, I was like my daughter on her first day of school when she was a kindergartner, my mom bought her a Grambling State shirt. And I was telling her, like, you know, this is if you guys actually look on their Instagram, my son is wearing an RBGU hoodie, my daughter is wearing a Grambling State shirt. And they really didn't know at the time what that means. You know, they're always used to getting clothes, but I'm sitting there telling them, I'm like, you know, that's dad's college and that's dad's business. And that's something that they can hold on to, that when they grow up, they can see that, you know, they can even hear, I think they're in the game room right now, so they can hear dad talking about, you know, his college and his business. This is something that, like I said, we made RBGU to have something that we needed growing up.
And so my kids, they can see this. And when I say, you know, my kids, it's not just about them. It's about those guys next door. It's about that kid from New York messaging us saying, hey, coach, I'm out of state. Any advice you can give me? Or a kid right. all from New Mexico.
And saying, I get that a lot. And those, trust me, those people that are in my DM, I'm getting to you. So just know that I got that. I got a list of.
We see that.
I got a person. I got a person in Australia. I got a person in, I think, Canada, Winnipeg. Yeah. So that's, you know, I am very one thing about that, just because you touched on that, I do want to give you guys as much time and as much information to answer them back to you. So I will definitely answer your questions on your DMs. Just give me a minute. So I appreciate the time, and we definitely need to do this some more, because I think this might be our first one. Out of five years, 2 years, 3 years.
Hey, since 2016.
Yeah.
My first time. And you know what I'm going to do? I'm hoping y'all can hear me clearly, because what I'm going to do is I'm going to save this video. And I seen Coach Chato, Coach Moran. He was talking about RBGU podcast. I'm going to take this audio, rip it off the video, and upload it for the first RBGU podcast.
Definitely.
And I was trying to, and for everybody, because I know it's Friday, so you guys are probably riding around, you know, eating. You guys aren't tuning in right now. You'll tune in a little bit later. But for those of you guys who love Coach Randle, I've been trying to get Coach Randle to do a podcast for a long time, for 2 years now, because
he has the book's coming.
Hey, I was about to say that.
The book's coming.
I was about to say that. So,
hey, how did DJ Khaled say? Special alert, the book's coming. Get in the book, baby.
Hey, I told, look. For those who might not, you know, be able to sit down for a podcast, Coach Randle got a book coming. It's gonna be out for all to read, for all to be motivated by.
Oh yeah.
I seen Coach Randle talk at the Black College Expo. I seen Coach Randle talk at the HBCU Combine. It's a lot of young kids. It's a lot of information out there that I can tell you guys right now. I know your attention spans are kind of short, and you guys might not want to sit down. It's easier to look at World Star Hip Hop in the Shade Room and be entertained, right? Yeah. But
TikTok.
TikTok. Is where you guys want that real quick stuff. But there's information out there that's for you. It's stuff that you guys aren't gonna learn in high school. You know, I know you guys, you know, your parents are banging high school into your head and banging school into your head. There's some things that gonna tell you there. And you're gonna have to go find it for yourself. You're gonna have to use an iPad, you know, use a cell phone, figure it out, use a computer. You're gonna have to Google how to, you know, I want to do this, you know, and it's 2020 now. It's a lot of things you can have, but Coach Randle has a lot of information for you guys, from sports to being a father, to being a dad, to being a coach.
Even being a son of a major league baseball player, Lenny Randle. Boom. You can look up my dad. Look that man
Boom.
Up.
Boom.
That man being, got some being Yankees, Mets, Mariners, Cubs, Rangers, 9 years in Italy.
That's crazy, because look, Coach Randle is a son of a pro to being a pro himself. And now he has a son that's the son of a pro and grandson of a pro. So it's like, it's a lot, man. It's a lot. It's a
Shout
lot
out to my son, Bryce Randle, too, by the way. I love you, boy. We're going to make you like Aaron Donald, boy. I know you want to play quarterback and wide receiver, but you're going to be the next Aaron Donald. Anyways, Mike, man, I appreciate the time. Thank you for the people that's I cut out? Okay, I'm back.
Follow us on Facebook. Hey, coaches, and not only, you know, we're not.
Hey,
we're not
give stingy. All the information.
We're not stingy.
Do all the social media.
I got you. Hey, coaches out there, we're not stingy. We know you guys might be watching and seeing how we do this drill. Go ahead and follow us on Facebook at RBGU2. Just put it in the search bar. We're there. All of our workouts will be there. You can follow us. I see a lot of coaches from different areas hit us up on Facebook. Players, RBGU2, you can find, that's everywhere. That's on Twitter, that's on Snapchat, that's Instagram, RBGU2, because we are just the second out. We're just another arm of Coach Randle. RBGU is just another arm of Coach Randle. You know, he can't talk to you guys all the time. He can't always post. So RBGU2.
But you can stay updated with everything that's going to be happening on those social media.
Yes, sir. You can stay updated with all that stuff. Social media, we're updating. If it's not daily, it's every other day. We don't want to be too repetitive. We want to get.
So break it down for me, Mike. Break it down for me. We got the Twitter, right?
We got the Twitter at RBGU2. We got Facebook. It's Running Back Guru University. We got the Snapchat. It's RBGU2. Just put a two, number two at the end of that. We also have a booking website that for everybody who wants to deal with Coach Randle. I know the pandemic. Oh, we got the YouTube. Shout out to Chato over to YouTube.
We got YouTube's popping.
But we have a booking site for all the players. Like we said, if you're in Texas, if you're in New Mexico, if you're in Florida, my buddy, if you are in Europe, we can train you. We can give you information. We can help you out. Coach Randle is there for
you.
And
I know tap in.
The world is in a pandemic right now. So for parents who are kind of shaky, you're like, I don't know. We have a COVID-safe training session. We have one-on-ones with Coach Randle. We have specific groups where it's no more than five people, and you guys are all spread out, getting intense work, sweating, getting it in. You guys can book Coach Randle. You can also book him by going to the link in his bio, going to RBGU. There's a big, beautiful sign that says book now. All information's in there. If you think your son's a fourth grader, Zoom. Yes, sir. If you book us, you can Zoom train you. But if you think your son's a fourth grader and it might be a little too intense, we have a Navy session for him that kind of just gets you going, get your heart pumping, get you sweating, test your might. And then if you think your son is on JV and you're like, man, that coach not really showing him no love, bring him to RBGU. You know, we'll get that
handcrafted. Handcrafted weaponry.
Yes, we'll get that chisel out what you think is right. So just come on over, book now, RBGU, links in bio. It's all you guys need to know.
I do have the Snapchat. So my actual Snapchat, if you guys want to see everything on a day-to-day basis, where I'm at, who I'm with, who I'm around, what am I doing, what time do I wake up, what do I read, if I'm with Rashad Penny, Elijah Penny, Dwayne Washington, some CFL players, it's all on my own personal Snapchat. It is the... It's br_Hollywood. There it is.
Yes, sir.
But anyways, Mike, I appreciate your time, my man. We'll do this again. We might have to do this again next Friday, bro. If you got time.
I think so.
Hey, after the kids are done with online class.
Oh boy, I just took a nap. I was like, yo, y'all go to sleep.
Here's a
nap.
Yeah. All right, man. I'll catch you in a minute, bro.
All right, boy.
All right, peace.
Yes, sir.
Let me see how I get out of here. I think I go like this. There you go. Hey, so that's a lot of information right there. That's a lot of information. It's all for you. So Marietta, Temecula, Lake Elsinore, Wildomar, Menifee. I think I've gone as far as San Diego and Pacific Beach. But if you guys need some help, if you guys need some information, if you guys need some motivation, I'm here for you, man. Just tap in with me one time. Hope all is well. Happy Friday to you. Let me show you the jerseys one more time. That one's mine. That one's Rashad's. And that's that. I'm getting my high school jersey too, by the way. This is Marietta. Shout out to Broncos out there. Peace. God bless. Ooh.
Black Twitter was that when jackets paid. Do you for everyone? Gucci support two Fubus. Sipping Crippa Cola, consumer and a owner. Till we all vertically integrated from the flow up. Do say power, sip ace till I throw up. Like gang signs, sip I bang minds for both ya. Serial entrepreneur, we on our own. Stop sitting around waiting for folks to throw you a bone. If you can't buy the building, at least stock the shelf. Then keep on stacking till you stocking for yourself. See everything you place after black. It's too small a term to completely describe the act. Black nation, black builder, black entrepreneur.